political crisis, and consequent to that, you know, the present government headed by KCR is heralding anarchy, and rule of law has been flouted, constitutional provisions have been subverted. I think this is a unique case where there is a treasury fund, there is a flexi, other than treasury, there is a flexi political fund which is created, which is demolishing the constitutional institution like legislatures. And our Congress President Rahul Ji is very particular, very serious, that the nation has to be seized of this crisis, you know, otherwise, just like a blood cancer in a democracy, this kind of a corrupt actions and also abusing the political and other institutions, constitutional institutions, will continue and perpetuate everywhere. I am not going to say, repeat what other friends have already said. We have passed a 1985. In fact, during Rajiv Gandhi's time, the constitution has been amended. Number 10 schedule has been added against the anti-defection law. This was meant to cleanse the political environment. This is meant, you know, that Aya Ram Gaya Ram culture is halted too. But a state like Telangana today, or even the BJP party by their Operation Lotus, they have institutionalized defection. This is what our president of the Congress party, Rahul Gandhi, is concerned. Of course, our mandate will be, and we are going to come back to power after this election, under the leadership of Rahul Gandhi and under the unity of the opposition parties, we are going to demolish undemocratic party like the BJP and their allies. And that is why we would like to amend the Anti-Defection Act so that court will have teeth, the law will have teeth, and those who commit gross corruption and abuse of the institution and ultimately demolish democratic structure like the legislature or the parliament will have to be appropriately, seriously dealt with. That amendment which we are going to bring, which is going to, you know, put these such people behind bars, you know, will have a retrospective effect. So that meant action, commission and omission on the part of the Chief Minister of Telangana and his associates, and also the MLAs who defect, will be covered, and we are going to seriously address this problem at the national level also. Apart from that, we have a Lokpal Act, which is now, Lokpal has been constituted. This was an act passed by the UPA 2 government, and I was the law minister to draft this. And maybe our leaders are thinking that this will be the first complaint before the Lokpal against the Chief Minister of Telangana. That will be the first complaint which will be launched there. I don't think he can prevail upon the Lokpal institution to block this kind of a move. This is only, not only a case of corruption, it is also a question of abuse of power, giving the office of profit, officers of profit, and also committing corruption with the money and Uttamji has already said that these are all, you know, drafted in the CM's office with the same typewriting, same types, everything, same language. This will be substantial evidence against the chief minister. This will be a substantial evidence against the chief. He can escape today, but he cannot escape tomorrow or thereafter. He will have to suffer for this. Let him halt this. Halt this process of abusing or corrupting the political people in a big, big way. And of course, we have to be blamed for creating a Frankenstein like the KCR in Telangana. We have done it for the sake of Telangana. Today we have done it for the sake of the people of Andhra Pradesh. Done for the, not for the sake of KCR. Of course, we created this kind of a Frankenstein, and that Frankenstein cannot, you know, go on abusing the office. Or, you know, the just because he has become, I don't think, you know, the maybe people must have elected him, but they are not elected for this. They have elected him for governing the state, maintain the rule of law, and this is a issue we will not spare. Today or tomorrow, you will have to be punished. He will be punished. Lokpal, inevitably, when the complaint is filed, he can block the speaker here, or he can block the assembly or the council chairman, but he cannot block the Lokpal there from issuing notice to against him. First, the notice is issued against him by the Lokpal. The law will take its own course, and ultimately, he will have to suffer for the omission and commission which he has done. So this is what we are thinking. We are taking political action and also legal action. Both will be done, and we are going to take it up as a national issue, because this kind of a practice cannot be practiced by any chief minister, any legislature, and we are going to address. We are very sorry that, you know, the one of the novel, unique legislation like the anti-defection in the Constitution of India have been subverted. And I must also say, this is not only subverting one provision, but it is subverting the entire constitutional process. Demolition of the constitutional institutions will be the biggest sin in a democratic country. We will fight it out. Our entire party will take up at the national level, and we'll extend all support to the state unit to take this issue further and not to lay down. And, you know, I don't think Congress can be counted down, and, you know, by this kind of a sabotage of the democratic institution. Thank you.